Jeremy, it appears that a couple of different things are happening at the same time as the Miami Heat play to save their season or end with another offseason of do they need to blow the whole thing up? It's been a very inconsistent and frustrating season for the Miami Heat because I do believe that the analysis of this Heat team can be but won't be. Holy shit, they got a lot of people hurt this season and a lot of different lineups. And then, yes, Jimmy got older. And even if they are a little better around Jimmy, that's pretty terrible luck. I don't think that the noisiness of an offseason when the expectations are where they are, right? I've thought recently a lot about how the Patriots fan base is experiencing the last couple of seasons, how the Warriors fan base experiences this season. You get used to so much success that when you get 47 wins on a team that had a lot of injuries, nobody wants to hear anything related to the injuries. So you've got a lot of Heat fans who are already mad, but they seem to also be mad at this show's analysis of the Heat. So what is the correct analysis? What is supposed to be the correct analysis of the Miami Heat when they lose to a Philadelphia team that's very good on the road by 1 point, and they are one of the top teams in the conference? And in a one-game sample, you had your chance to win the game and have an easier path, but you blew it, at least in part, because your key player got hurt very early.
Yeah, I think that's a huge part of it, Dan, is injuries have sort of summarized this season, and for that matter, the entire Jimmy Butler era, right? There's a lot of people who think the Heat could have beat the Lakers in the finals had Goran Dragic and Bam Adebayo not been hurt for that series. Jimmy Butler had a bum ankle for the second part of that Eastern Conference run last year after Josh Hart fell into his legs against the Knicks. And the same thing sort of happened where the wheels fell off at the end. So you look at this one game sample and you got a guy who has a knee injury as the best player on the team. It's built around a team that had the most starting lineups in team history. And that becomes part of the narrative. But you also know that this team went into last offseason after reaching the finals going after Dame Lillard, right? They knew there were things that could have or should have changed and found their way to piece things together to get to this point this year. Now you go into Friday night hoping for the best, but going into a potential series
against
Boston
tonight
with some trouble. I'm
history,
taking them.
That's tonight.
I'm still taking them. I don't think they're going to win a game against the Celtics, but they're beating the Bulls tonight.
That Woo. Is bold by Chris Cody. History does not remember the injuries. Kawhi Leonard won the title, not Kevin Durant and Clay were hurt. History, the more days that go by, nobody cares. Nobody wants to hear it. Let's open up the Cuervo Club.
That's right, it's the club. It's our favorite time of the week because the week is over. Brought to you by Cuervo. Now's a good time to enjoy tequila that invented tequila. We love Cuervo. They crushing it with the MMA hangouts. We're having a lot of fun, Dan. Are you having fun? It's Friday. The energy's good. How are you feeling, Dan?
I'm assuming that I could predict the first sound in the club. The club is getting open. I'm assuming. I don't know for sure because Mike Tyson is sprinting through it.
You there.
You just
ever said that.
I just assumed. I assumed that it would
Dan,
be.
Dan, you should have known. You should have known it was going to be me messing up.
You're so right. Dan is right. This was the best sound of the week.
Who else is in the club?
That's hey, Drifter.
Greg Cody likes to be greeted with, hey,
Drifter. Hey, Drifter.
Stugatz likes to be greeted with, hey, Grifter. Who else is in the club?
He just ever said that. He's lashing out.
That is Tony leaning into Drake lyrics that he didn't do correctly.
He ever said that.
Swip the flitch. What was I saying?
Who idiot.
Else, who else is in the club?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's it.
I don't remember what
was that?
What was
oh,
that?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Yeah, that's it.
Is that James Gandolfini?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that's it.
Wait a minute. That's disgusting. It's hairy. It's sweaty. It's large. It's bloated. What the hell was that?
Greg Cody making a weird noise.
Was that him just trying? That was him like a puppy starts running on a tile floor and its feet are moving.
Perfect
but it's
visual.
Not moving. That's Greg coughing up before
exactly
speaking.
Right.
Before a thought comes out coherently. Who else is in the Cuervo Club?
No, I thought it generally sucked.
That guy's awesome.
Fairbanks.
I didn't think it was a specific suck. I thought it was like an all-encompassing type of suck.
It's so good. That needs to be a t-shirt. It was an all-encompassing type of suck.
I didn't
suck.
Think it was a specific suck. I thought it was like an all-encompassing type of suck.
We got to have him on. I like that guy.
I mean, he blew a save, and he said it was an all-encompassing
suck. I didn't think it was
suck.
A specific suck. I thought it was like an all-encompassing
it
type of suck.
It should be a stat. Instead of blown save, all-encompassing
S-U-C.
All-encompassing suck. Who else is in the Cuervo Club?
It looks like a David Sampson crowd at a vineyard.
Come on.
Jalen.
What?
Jalen.
That was Taylor singing a terrible song about the Knicks.
That's a Jalen Brunson song? Why Jaylen. Is he allowed to sing songs around here?
Jalen.
He makes bangers, Dan.
Marlins lead the league in all-encompassing type of sucks.
Roger Clemens standing right in George Steinbrenner's box.